I like to monitor this other hand, because if this one's coming out, whether it be a hit, a push, a grab, I already know what that one's doing. But I don't always know what this one's about to do. So why wait, right? So we're just gonna do a little quick drill. So when that jab starts to come, as I cover, I wanna cover this hand, right? So I'm thinking of this. The idea is he's punching and pulling back. So as he punches, I'm gonna track with this. So as I cover, I've already covered this one. So what I wanna think about is, when I come here, right away, my hand is already where? Right in this position. As he's retracting this, I'm gonna hit, come back and take this one. So what I wanna think about is one, two, hit underneath, come back, and then I'm gonna take this one. From here, right back in my arm brackets, right? So I can come back and pick that hit. So it looks just like this. So I go one, two, three, four. And I'll slow it down one more time, change angle just a little bit. So as I tap, now this is not just a tap. I want to strike this, whether it be with my knuckles or with the back of the wrist. So when I come in, he should be feeling a little ow. See what I mean? So one, whether it be eye poke, could be what, thumb to the neck. If I'm deep, slap to the back of the head, more than likely it's gonna be here. He's already retracting this, so if I can punish this arm on the way there, I'm gonna go ahead and get another contraction, right? So one, two, three, four. So as I go one, two, retract. Notice how this comes under and then it comes up. Now, what's important is when I come here, this hand is already what? It's covering that elbow. So this gives me the space. If that other hand's coming, I'm still where? So the whole time I wanna, whether it's a hitting hand or covering hand, right? It's the same thing. This is already covering, but it could be covering blocking, so to speak, right? But really, it could be what? Just the hit. So I'm doing the same thing regardless of necessarily the outcome for that moment. That being said, he gets hit, he gets blocked and then hit. So it's either you get hit now, you get hit later. What's the overall theme? You're gonna get hit, okay. It's just a matter of when. So one, two, three, four. And then you have your arm bar. Here, if you retract, I go with it and then I arm drag back, okay? Here right away, I've got position where I like to turn the chin right away. So we're just gonna use this. If you wanna go with arm drag, that's fine. You just wanna stick with this part. So one, two, three, four, here, this way. Because natural, when I go to do the arm bar, if I get a great arm bar, but naturally he wants to what? He's gonna contract. When he does, I go with it. So if I end up here, it's the same thing. Even look, inside now, I just go here. Same movement. I'm still back into all of this. So you get what you get. I can go low and hit the hip, right? So if I miss the arm, I'm still where? Right on the hip. See what I mean? So it could be right away back into this technique here on the opposite side. Where earlier you guys were doing it out here, right? Well, we do the same thing out here. Or out here. Out here. Looks a lot like the same catch you did off the head, right? See what I mean? Still go back into the arm drag. So this is more of a playing with the hands. So even here, boom. Or in this case, one, two, hit, come under. If you think of like a gunting action, So I'm still covering myself the whole time. I've already taken both arms for a moment, or what? I made them contract. If he tries to hook this, see how this, I can go in, I can come around, doesn't really matter. I can still pull and go this way. See how this, he goes to pull it away, I move this one to that one. He thinks he has something, he hooks. Still back here, see how this. Even if I get caught on the inside here, all I have to do is move it out of my way. So, boom, one, two, four. Still got there, right? I just went, okay, now I need to bring this hand down out of my way. Because it's simple, it either goes over or it goes under, or it goes in. Okay. I do my technique. Over, into the bicep, under the bicep. Striking, striking, striking. If you're close enough, I get a what? You get an atemi right away. Even just raking across the throat, the fingertips, you get a contraction in the neck, right? Even worse if I use, you see what I mean? Anything to slow him down, get to the body. So if I can't get the face, I go what? Here, he's retracting this back. I can still hit it. On this, instead of coming down, it gets hit on the way back up. See what I mean? So different points in time, I'm gonna be able to hit this. So pop. Hit, hit, get hit. So if you just want to try the rip, just to get a feeling, of course, you're going to get a different outcome. But my goal is if that hand comes up, I want him to know I know where his hands are. So the main, he goes to punch, boom, he's hit. So right away, even here, down, over. So you'll eventually see this way. Or I push it slightly up, or I push it over and go under. So different combinations of this same idea. Delayed. See what I mean? But I always want to think of, I want to know where this other arm is. Okay? Arm drag again, right? So it just pops up everywhere. But try this concept. One, two, three, four, rotate, and then you have your bar. He retracts, move with it. So I go with it. When he pulls back, I just pull down into my arm drag. There's the control of the hip. I'm back into my cervical lock, little short leechy, elbow, poke to the eye. So, hit, hit, hit. If that hand's coming, I still get the arm bar, it's just I hit him in the face again.